it was all good just a week ago. In the words of Jay-Z featuring Too Short, it was all good just a week ago. Y'all heard it. John Fury sounding insanely worried for his son heading into the Wilder trilogy fight. What does this mean? We're going to talk about all that and also examine some of his past statements of Wilder when he said Wilder was making excuses. And we'll see if it all adds up in this here video. Stay tuned. What up, fight world? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button, also subscribe to my channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. Make sure you click the link in the description to sign up for TubeBuddy. What are you on YouTube for if you don't want to make money? You don't want your message, your videos seen and heard? This can increase your discoverability and searchability by optimizing your video and your content so the world gets to see it. I've been using TubeBuddy, start off with zero subscribers. Now we're over 200,000 viewers plus and counting. We doing numbers, millions of views later. I promise you we work in 2021 is up. Consider TubeBuddy like I have for the last several years and level up your YouTube content. Use my link in the description. Let's go. Now, we got to talk about it. You see this, DAZN, it says John Fury upset at Tyson Fury versus Anthony Joshua fallout. He's worried about the Deontay Wilder fight, which begs and poses the question for all considered. If you know what he said, I've made videos about this, but I want to revisit it. John Fury did this interview, an exclusive interview where he's sitting down and he's talking about how he preferred Tyson, his son, fight Joshua. Things were set up. He doesn't prefer the Wilder fight. He says, why are we fighting Wilder again? But who am I? I'm just some voice that nobody's listening to. Things can go wrong. He says fighting Wilder in a trilogy fight could be a mistake. He's hoping Tyson Fury is not complacent. You know what? I'm going to let you listen for yourself. Roll the clip.
Fighting AJ. I want him to fight AJ. I'm no interest in Deontay Wilder. So why has he got to fight Wilder? I told him on a phone conversation, chuck the belt in the bin, let him have it, come back and fight AJ on the 14th of August like was planned. But who am I? I'm nobody, unfortunately. A voice that only a certain amount of people hear.
And then you've got the detractors, like AJ's camp, claiming that they never wanted, Tyson never wanted it in the first place.
Rubbish. Rubbish. I'm just concerned whether Tyson can raise his game for Wilder. Whether he gets complacent, makes a mistake, you know, but I don't know. It's got every chance of going wrong out there. Because I don't like how it's been handled. It's been badly handled. You know, and that's just my opinion. No one else's. Tyson knows what he's doing. But I said, get back on a plane. Let's have a look at the situation proper. Let's assess it.
Obviously, he beat him very convincingly last time. I mean, arguably beat him the first time. Is there a danger that he just thinks he can just turn up and walk through him again?
The danger point is getting fair play out there. At the minute, the American boxing fraternity has been embarrassed from last escapade. Why wouldn't you take a $20 million step aside without fighting and a guaranteed shot at the winner when you're fighting for a lot less money than $20 million and you're risking getting your skull caved in again? It don't make sense on his part. So obviously, the powers that be in America are involved, aren't they?
There you guys just heard it for yourself. Tyson Fury's own father sounding insanely worried for his son. Now, all these things he was listing out, he was saying the American fraternity, you know, it says Tyson Fury versus Anthony Joshua is no longer happening. John Fury has had his say. John Fury, the father of WBC heavyweight champion Tyson Fury, had his say on his son's upcoming fight with Wilder. Tyson appeared set on Joshua, which was all cap, lost to arbitration. And this is what he said in the exclusive interview. So we can skip past all the cap on my channel. I want to give you more facts and none of that cap. So this is what happens when you get to the top. There's a lot of leeches out there, a lot of hangers-on, said John Fury. You can see what's happening in America with him. Appalling work, to be honest with you. It's diabolical, isn't it? So that's one statement. Then he says, you're geared up to fight one man. All of a sudden, on the 11th hour, it's all sorted. In 24 hours, he's signing contracts in a whole other boxing venue. They're around him like locusts. I'm thinking to myself, how can he think straight? Fury added, he can blame his team, no one else. Anything rushed is no good, and that's been rushed. He was fighting Anthony Joshua. I wanted him to fight Anthony Joshua. You see it, this is not like my opinion. This is John Fury saying this. He says, I had no interest in Deontay Wilder. I told Tyson Fury on the phone, in a phone conversation, to chuck the belt in the bin, let Wilder have it, and fight AJ on August 14th as was planned. So this sounds insane. If this is not worry, then I don't know what is. Father of Tyson Fury says, throw the belt away in the trash can and go into the Joshua fight, which would no longer be the undisputed fight that they said it was going to be. So that sounds pretty desperate. He says, I'm concerned whether Tyson Fury can raise his game for Wilder, whether he gets complacent, makes a mistake. It's got a good chance of going wrong out there. The danger point is getting fair play out there. At the minute, the American boxing fraternity has been embarrassed from the last escapade. Why wouldn't you take $20 million step aside without fighting in a guaranteed shot at the winner when you're fighting for a lot less money and you're risking getting your skull caved in again? It doesn't make sense. So obviously the powers that be in America are involved. They're calling the shots and trap them both. Wow. So ironic here. He's saying the powers that be. This sounds like this is some grand scheme to see Wilder fight Fury and all this stuff like that. But these all sound like excuses. So it's ironic when Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder says he felt funny. He visibly looked like more lethargic. He was blinking his eyes. And Wilder says all these things in the fight. He definitely didn't look like any version of Wilder we've seen in 40 fights or whatever. And Wilder says what he says. People say Wilder, oh, he's busy making excuses. But now you have John Fury who's saying openly, I had no interest in fighting Wilder, even though Fury was contracted to fight Wilder another time. They were trying to move past. If you have the complexion for the protection, white privilege in boxing is an amazing thing because you can say statements like this, I had no interest in Deontay Wilder. So basically, Tyson Fury's own father is on wax in an exclusive UK interview telling the world that he told Fury to duck Wilder and throw the belt in the trash bin, throw it away. He's saying these things. He's openly making these premeditated excuses. Things could go wrong and the American boxing fraternity, they're involved and they trapped them both. And it sounds ridiculous. But once again, when Deontay Wilder said what he said, people said Wilder was just making excuses. Now, I also feel a point worthy of noting is Fury has been accused of cheating. Now we know that Tyson Fury has got to fight Wilder on the up and up. It seems like a lot of worry for Tyson Fury's team, which is also not a good look. The moment you've been outed for being a cheater and you have to fight this knockout artist who has true power, unlike Fury, who walked down Wilder, something he hadn't done previously in his 12-year career against anybody elite. You know, he got dropped by Steve Cunningham, and he didn't even just walk through guys like Steve Cunningham, Safiri, Otto Vailin. He didn't just do that. But he's doing it to Wilder, making his ear bleed. Now, all of a sudden, John Fury is upset, and he's telling the world that it's a setup, and it just sounds like a bunch of excuses, and it sounds worried. Now, I tell you guys all the time, the most dangerous thing in this game is a camera and a microphone. You got to be held accountable for what you say and liable. And I think one of the ironic things is Wilder hasn't really said much. He won the arbitration. He hasn't really come out and done no exclusives. He just seems to be more or less training. He got his team situated. And they seem to just be working towards their common goal. He looks like he's in amazing shape. So Wilder's not even talking, yet you hear Team Fury and they have all these premeditated excuses. Now, I tell you, most dangerous thing, like I just said, camera and a microphone. This is an interview, a previous from Talk Sport, link in the description. Bold, John Fury in epic rant about BS, bullish, Deontay Wilder excuses. Says American is in denial and should sack his whole team for allowing him to fight Tyson Fury again. So ironic enough that September 2020, John Fury, just last year, when Fury was trying to evade Wilder, John Fury had all these things to say. Now he sounds super worried for his son and believes that things can go wrong. Says John Fury has ripped into Deontay Wilder and his camp over the excuses that emerged since his defeat to Tyson Fury. In the immediate rematch aftermath, Bronze Bomber suggested that the heavy ring outfit, blah, 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 contributed to his downfall, and he was widely mocked as a result. Wilder himself has made no excuses since, though some of his fans have put together various conspiracy theories. The most popular of these, dubbed Glovegate, reemerged back in June through Wilder's brother, yada, yada, yada. Tyson Fury's father, John Fury, reacted and says he shouldn't have fought him then, should he? Right? It's up to his team to say you're injured, you can't fight. To be honest with you, it's the biggest load of BS I've ever heard from a professional sportsman. He says you got to beat down, swallow it, look at it, assess it, and know where you went wrong. Build on it and work on what mistakes you made. Until you accept what's happened to you, it's what you call being in denial. You're not going to learn from it. You're not going to move on, right? This is the harsh criticism from John Fury. You're just going to get another beatdown for being silly because his ego is bigger than him. So John Fury in September 2020 is saying that Wilder is going to get another beatdown. And in Fury, we know after being outed for this article is kind of mocking, a UK article mocking Glovegate and saying that people made these lewd and ludicrous Glovegate excuses, right? And it says you're going to get another beatdown for being silly because your ego is bigger. Fast forward to Wilder winning the arbitration and enforcing Fury in a trilogy fight and a clean fight. He says, this is what happens when you're at the top. You're a lot of leechers and people hanging on. It's appalling. You geared up for one man. I had no interest in Deontay Wilder. In the war, like I opened the video, it was all good just a week ago. It says, shut up now with all these daft rubbish comments you're coming out with. It's absurd. It's a joke. I've never heard it from a professional sportsman just making yourself look bad. And the kid can fight. He's a good fighter, good defending champion. He did get a bad beatdown because of his corner. The only man he's got is Mark Breland. The rest don't know what they're doing. So these are all the harsh criticisms for Deontay Wilder, right? And then fast forward to the future, what is John Fury doing? It sounds like he's making excuses for Tyson Fury and the bell hasn't even rung. So you guys let me know in the comment section, what is the difference when Wilder had his say and he had his particular thoughts? People said he was making excuses. Now, John Fury sounds worried. They're even putting in the title, worried about Deontay Wilder fight. You guys tell me what's the difference. So how are we calling Wilder an excuse maker? And now Wilder's not saying anything. And Tyson Fury's team, Fury keep posting memes. And John Fury sounds worried for his son. You guys tell me what the difference is. I can't wait to read these comments.